I'm very lucky, she says, to have produced Paula Vogel, Edward Albee, Maggie Edson, and on and on, and had the honour of holding the record for 4 Pulitzer Prize-winning plays produced. As the mother of a gay son, Daryl thought it essential to revive Larry Kramer's The Normal Heart, for people to understand, sadly, that the subject of AIDS is still timely. Daryl cares deeply about the current important issues. I'm always thinking about ideas for marketing and how to better sell the shows I'm working on, she says. It's all about getting tushies in the seat. I think she'll be happy tonight, don't you? Linda Weiner taught critical writing at Columbia, was the chief theatre and dance critic at the Chicago Tribune from 1969 to 1980, and the critic for New York Daily News and USA Today. She was chief theatre critic of New York, She was chief theatre critic of Newsday from 1987 to 2017, not shabby. She has won many prizes, has taught at the Eugene O'Neill Theatre Centre, and has judged the Pulitzer Prize for Drama 9 times, 5 times as panel chair. When Linda is not out riding her favourite white horses around Van Cortlandt Park, actually it's only one horse I ever pass, she's usually at home with her husband, Pulitzer Prize winning music critic Martin Bernheimer, or at the theatre. But tonight, she's here with us to interview Daryl. I welcome to the stage Daryl Roth and Linda Weiner. Thank you.
Messaging that is akin to what you're interested in, you know, in putting out there for the world. I would say in that way, perhaps it hasn't changed. What I think has changed, at least in so far as what I look for, I think I've become maybe more daring and more willing to take risks. I've always felt that that would be my place in this world because I had to find a niche for myself. And I was very comfortable producing plays that were pushing the envelope a little bit. And I have found that by doing that and sort of addressing my own fears and my own, you know, anxieties about things in life, that I can find stories in theater that actually mean a lot to people. And so, I guess for me, my journey has been, and if this connects with Has Theater Changed, it's in trying to be a little more courageous, I guess I would say, in what I choose.
More courageous than the person who decided to produce wit about a woman dying of ovarian cancer, or how I learned to drive, about consensual pedophilia, and incest. I'm sorry, almost forgot incest. And more daring than Three Tall Women at a time when Edward Albee was not wanted here anymore. When you and Liz McCann, with whom you've produced
all the Albee plays
that we love, decided to produce Three Tall Women, that was a huge risk because nobody cared about Albee anymore. Hard to believe,
and it's true. You know, it seemed to me that, first of all, I read Edward Albee's plays when I was in college, and I just loved his work so much. Never did I think in my wildest dreams that I'd ever sit in the same room with him, let alone produce six of his plays. But I think at the time that Three Tall Women was done, and as you said, Edward was being produced mostly in Europe. Mm. It was kind of out of favor, you know, and yet his writing shone through as being so incredible, and the style with which he wrote Three Tall Women, which was about his mother at three stages in her life. And I'm happy to say there's a revival that is on Broadway, which I'm not producing, Liz and I are not producing. I sort of have the feeling that it has to be, someone else has to take the mantle, but glad that we did it originally, because we did reintroduce him to the American theater going public, and it was time, As far as Paul is how I learned to drive, I will say, that was a risky business, it was. But it was wonderful, and I just love her work, and Mary Louise Parker and David Morse, who starred in it. And they were just such treasures, and you can't shy away from those subjects. Wit, of course, was a different story. I guess that was pretty courageous. It was just something beautiful, and it was something, as I mentioned, that was scary to talk about for me, for everybody. It was the C word. And yet, the way Margaret Edson wrote the story with such care and such empathy about Professor Baring, who felt that she was not receiving empathy in her situation from her doctors in the hospital, it just brought out a very important subject that everyone in the world has to deal with at one point or another. And I felt that it was a door opener for a lot of people, and to come to see a play like that and be able to talk about it after, whether you are a caregiver or a cancer survivor or just someone who was touched by a story of a similar nature, it just was so rhapsodic in a way, that you kind of forgot the sadness and the terror about the subject, and you just took it to a place of humanity. Something I love to say about Wit, which is we invited different people involved in the medical profession to come and do our Tuesday talkbacks, as we called them, and we had a lot of medical professionals come, and someone had the wonderful idea to invite our cast to go to New York Hospital and perform some of the scenes, which we did. And it was such an amazing moment. As a result of it, they initiated classes in empathy. And that was something wonderful.